ഒരുപാട് എസ്തെറ്റിക്സ് ആവശ്യമുള്ള ഒരു കലയാണ് ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. അതിൻ്റെ കൂടെ ക്ഷമയും കൂടെ ചേരുമ്പോഴത്തേക്ക് വൈൽഡ് ലൈഫ് ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫി ആയി. എനിക്കൊന്നും ധനുഷിൻ്റെ മയക്ക എന്ന സിനിമയുടെ ശേഷമാണ് വൈൽഡ് ലൈഫ് ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫി ഇത്രയും അടിപൊളിയാണെന്നൊക്കെ എനിക്ക് തോന്നിയത് കേട്ടോ. സോ ഇതേ വൈൽഡ് ലൈഫ് ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫിയിൽ വ്യക്തിമുദ്ര പതിപ്പിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു വനിതയാണ് നമ്മൾ പരിചയപ്പെടാൻ പോകുന്നത്. മുംബൈ മലയാളിയായ ഐശ്വര്യ ശ്രീധറാണ്. ഒരുപാട് ഒരുപാട് അവാർഡുകൾ ലഭിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടെങ്കിലും 56 വർഷമുള്ള ചരിത്രം തിരുത്തിക്കുറിച്ച ഒരാളാണ്. കാരണം നമ്മുടെ ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് നാച്ചുറൽ ഹിസ്റ്ററി മ്യൂസിയത്തിൻ്റെ ഇൻ്റർനാഷണൽ വൈൽഡ് ലൈഫ് ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫി അവാർഡ് നേടി സംവിധാനത്തിലും ചെറുതായിട്ടൊന്ന് കൈവച്ച് പരീക്ഷിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്ന ഐശ്വര്യ ശ്രീധറിനെയാണ് നമ്മൾ പരിചയപ്പെടാൻ പോകുന്നത്.
Namaskaram, my name is Aishwarya Sridhar. I'm a wildlife filmmaker and photographer. My native is Palakkad in Kerala. So recently I received the highly commended award in the Behavior Invertebrate category at the 56th Wildlife Photographer of the Year. About 500 to 600 flamingos right behind me. So I've traveled to a lot of places across India to capture the stories of our biodiversity. So I've been to Penge, Kanha, Little Run of Kutch, Gir, Tadoba, Periyar, Silent Valley, then I've also been to Velavadar in Gujarat. So yeah, a lot of places across India. So right from childhood, I've been a child who's been an active participant in all competitions. In fact, I used to go a lot for elocution competitions, drawing competitions, etc. So my tryst with photography began when I was around 11 years old, when my father gifted me a point and shoot camera for my birthday. From childhood, I used to go on various wildlife treks with my father, and that kind of brought me closer to nature, and that's how my entire journey in wildlife began. So my earliest memory, in fact, of seeing the tiger was when I was around 10. So in Penge National Park, I saw my first wild tiger, and that experience was unforgettable. Challenges in wildlife photography, I feel that one of the biggest is being a girl, in fact. So there is this mental block in the society as such, that they don't think that girls can do outdoor jobs. So being a full-time wildlife filmmaker and photographer does have that thing that people don't accept you as normal in society. So that is one thing, because as girls they feel that, you know, you're just meant to do a desk job and be a housewife as such. So they really don't think of girls or women to be able to go out and, you know, explore nature and be up to adventures. So that's a big challenge. So actually I received the award for my image of fireflies, Minna Mini. So fireflies are basically, you know, they're a very magical creature, and I have seen fireflies from my childhood. In fact, I've grown up trying to catch fireflies in my balcony. So I've always wanted to photograph it from the beginning, and when a chance presented itself in 2019 in the month of June, I went along gladly. So it was at Bhandardara in Maharashtra where I captured that image. So the Wildlife Photographer of the Year is a very prestigious competition that is held annually in London by the Natural History Museum. So across the world, all the top photographers participate in that competition. So to be able to win the award at that level was a very big surprise for me, and I was like, I was really happy and grateful to God for having given me that chance. support from the family has always been there. My mom and dad, both of them are also wildlife lovers, so they have always encouraged me to be in this field. And my extended family did have a problem. They felt that, you know, being a girl, you can't be in a male dominated industry like this, and it's not safe for girls out there. You shouldn't be doing this. Do a desk job or study well. Why are you going into media? Because a lot of times, you know, people feel that media, girls in the media are not intelligent. But that is one perception I feel that you have to change. I think wildlife filmmaking or any filmmaking as such requires a lot of creativity, and it does really need brains.
And many more. I clicked these images, a few of them 2 years ago, and out of them, there are a few species I haven't seen again in the wild. The thought of that actually scares me, that these are the last visuals I have of a species. These images actually represent everything that we had and everything that we might never have.
In the future, I really hope that I can make more stories of our biodiversity and showcase it to the world. I want to be one of India's number one wildlife filmmakers and to be able to bring wildlife films to global mainstream media. And also, I want to try my hand at on-screen camera hosting for television shows.
He decides to head towards the thorny undergrowth, which would provide him the perfect camouflage and safety he needs during molting. Emerge with a new shiny skin until it's time to mold again.